children often complain of stomach pain, and this is the most common reason that parents bring them to emergency. So usually what happens that, toddlers and adolescents age group, you know, they'll have stomach pain on and off, and then it goes away with, you know, some kind of treatment. And the parents get concerned, you know, when they should be concerned about the child and what they need to do about this stomach pain, which is coming so frequently to the child. So today we are going to, understand what is stomach pain or chronic or recurrent stomach pain in children and what we can do about it. So if you look at the definition, chronic pain is something that which has been ongoing for at least 1 to 2 months, and if you say it is recurrent, then you know if the child is having more than 3 episodes or when it is affecting the daily activity of the child, then it is recurrent. If the episodes have been ongoing for 3 months, then we can say it is a recurrent or chronic abdominal pain. So in that case, there are certain factors or things that the parents need to remember, to look into, what is causing this pain and how it can be helped. So let's look into the causes of this abdominal pain. So, they are actually divided into organic causes and functional causes. Now, organic causes is that if there is underlying disorder in any of the organ system involved, whenever there is an underlying organic cause, the child will have some kind of warning signs, and these warning signs are very important. So if your child is vomiting very frequently or having constipation, diarrhea, or unable to sleep, if you see significant behavioral change, if the child is not able to carry out the daily activity, or if there is alternation in bowel and bladder habits, for example, the child has started staining the pants or having incontinence, or if you see any amount of blood in stool or urine, then obviously these are the warning signs which suggest that there is an underlying organic cause. Now let's look what are the organic causes. So most commonly that we see in toddlers and adolescent children which have frequent or recurrent abdominal pain, the two most common causes, constipation and food allergies. And yes, I would like to emphasize on these causes because nowadays our kids are very much exposed to, processed food containing a lot of preservatives. And this is something which is affecting them in a big way. Secondly, if you look as compared to the past, nowadays the activity level of the kids have gone down a lot. So most of the time you'll see small kids spending their time on mobile phones, watching tablets. Similarly, older kids as well, they have little time for physical activity and they are mostly engrossed in their tablets or computers. So this is something which is really, really contributing big time to these common factors. And food allergy is coming big time in our country as well because of exposure of too many food products. Obviously, the pollution level has gone up, which goes into your soil as well. So whatever you eat is not actually very, very healthy. So there are certain factors, which needs to be looked into. And then there are other causes, for example, like infection, your common gastroenteritis, kidney or bladder infection. Then there are causes related to food poisoning. There are causes related to, excessive drug overdose. Then there are certain surgical causes, which may give rise to severe abdominal pain. And besides that, there are other stomach conditions, for example, like chronic condition like pancreatitis, inflammatory bowel disease. But they will be associated with other, factors as well, disease modalities to be able to diagnose this disease. Now, besides the organic disorders, there are functional disorders which can give rise to abdominal pain in children. The most common functional disorder is functional dyspepsia, which is now again very commonly seen in kids. In common language, we call it stomach upset. Most kids, will complain of, burning pain, and this is not associated with any bowel movements. So this stomach upset, bloating or feeling of burning is usually called functional dyspepsia. Then there are other causes like irritable bowel syndrome, abdominal migraine, and other functional disorders. So So these are certain causes which as a parent you need to remember that, you know, if the child is having recurrent or chronic abdominal pain, they might be suffering from one of these problems. So how do we diagnose this stomach pain? So basically, whenever you are worried, you should consult your doctor or a specialist. When the child goes to the hospital, a couple of tests are being done based on the underlying pathology. These usually include a blood test, a stool and a urine test, and x-ray or ultrasound depending on, as I said earlier, on the underlying cause. If needed, the child may need an endoscopy to look at any specific, you know, organ or any specific pathology. Now, it's very important to keep a pain diary because that is very, very helpful in charting out these recurrent abdominal pain which comes on and off. And usually, you know, as a parent also, it also helps you. So what you need to know in the pain diary is how bad the pain, how long it lasted, did it affect it, any of the activity like sports or, you know, playtime or school. Was there any trigger involved? Was it related to any food or, you know, any stress? And what was the location of the pain? And finally, did it get relieved by anything? So these are certain things as a parent that you can do because this is very, very helpful in diagnosing and knowing this recurrent abdominal pain. Now, what is the treatment which will be advised? So treatment is obviously based on the underlying pathology, but at home as a parent, what you can do to the child who's having abdominal pain is try and keep the child hydrated, offer them plenty of fluid or juices or, you know, clear liquids like coconut water. Don't push the child to eat. I know most of the parents get worried when the child is not eating, but you know, once the pain settles, the child automatically wants to eat. So if the child feel hungry, then offer them bland food like dalia, khichdi or some soft you know, toast or something. And important thing is allow the child to have plenty of rest. If needed, you can give a simple dose of paracetamol to help with the abdominal pain. But if you see any of the following, you know, warning signs, then I think you should always rush to emergency. So what are the warning signs that you see and you should take the child immediately to emergency or to the doctor? So if the child, besides having the stomach pain, is having fever, high fever with chills, is repeatedly vomiting, having blood in their stool, or are not able to pass urine, or if anything that concerns you regarding the child, then the best thing is to take the child to the nearest emergency or, you know, to the nearest hospital. In the end, I would like to conclude that recurrent stomach pain in children is treatable provided you take the right advice at the right time.